سبيل الدموع سبيل مريح تنهدى يا صاحي كي تستريح.
Our sisters, our brothers, our children, they need to be empowered. They need to be empowered psychologically, they need to be empowered emotionally, they need to have the courage that even if the whole of society is against them, or the whole of society tells them to do one thing, they say, if my religion says the opposite, I choose my religion. We need to empower our children to be able to stand up to society. Otherwise, the tide is very strong and the tide will take them. The tide is very strong and the tide will take them. We need to remind our children that Islam is not theoretic. Yani when Allah Azza wa Jal tells us all throughout the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ وَاصْبِرُوا إِلَى الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. All about sabr. What sabr? When does a person have sabr? Can anyone tell me the three times a person is meant to have sabr? Three times a person needs to be patient. Time number one, on good deeds. To be patient on good deeds. You have to be patient, you have to have sabr. To wake up for Fajr every day, to give your zakat, to give your sadaqah, to read your Quran every day, to wear your hijab properly every day. You have to have sabr to make dua, you have to have sabr to come to the lessons, you have to have sabr to memorize, you have to have sabr to keep doing your dhikr every day. You have to have sabr to do these things. If you don't have sabr, you won't maintain it, you won't keep it up, you won't be consistent, and you'll drop off. Second time you have to have sabr is to keep away from the sins. This is sabr, this needs sabr. You need to have sabr to not look at the haram, to not speak the haram, to not listen to the haram, to not watch the haram. You need to have sabr to stay away from being, yani, going get a brand new car so easily, yani, on finance, to get a house so easily on finance. You need to have sabr. It's not easy to stay away from all of that haram all the time. You need to have sabr. You need to have sabr to make sure you don't fall into zina, you don't drink alcohol, you don't gamble. You need to have sabr. And the third one is to be sabr on calamities. If something strikes you, from good or bad, you need to be patient with it to make sure you only use it or say or react in a way that pleases Allah Azza wa Jal. You need to be patient. These three times, everyone knows the last one, everyone. But not many people know the first two. When we tell our children, be patient. The only time we tell them be patient is when something bad, like qadrullah, happens. But tell them to be patient upon the deen. No one knows. If patience and these things weren't meant to be implemented or went to be very easy, why would the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell us that there will come a time when holding on to your deen will be like what? Holding on to hot coal, kal jamra. Don't we all know this hadith? Haven't we all heard this hadith before? We all have heard this hadith before. Our children know this hadith, but they don't know how to implement the hadith. And this is one problem that's causing a personality disorder in our children. They're confused in their identity because they know all of these ahadith. They know these ayat about patience, they know it. But they don't find a place where they actually need to implement it. And that's because they've made everything halal. So on the one hand, they're meant to be patient upon the good deeds. On the other hand, they live as if everything is halal. And we need to combat that to the best of our ability. We need to empower them to understand that even if your whole school does their eyebrows, oh girls, you don't do your eyebrows. Because the Prophet ﷺ said this, and Allah Azza wa Jalla created you this way, and Allah Azza wa Jalla loves purity, and whether you understand or you don't understand, ultimately what Allah chooses for you is the best. And when you're patient upon that, not only do you get the reward of Allah Azza wa Jalla in the hereafter, wallah, all of these girls with their eyebrows, wallah, you'll be the happiest one. Because Allah Azza wa Jalla places happiness in the heart and contentment and tranquility in the hearts of the people who hold firm onto His deen. Whereas all of these people, wallah, you think that they're making themselves happy, wallah, every single one is depressed and miserable, and go ask them yourself. We need to teach them. Allah will give you what wallah the whole world is looking for, but they'll never get it because you can only find it in the deen of Allah. But you need to be patient upon that. It's not going to come easily. It's not going to come swiftly. It's not going to come on a platter of gold and silver. No. You need to be patient upon it.
فَبِاللَّهِ كَمْ تَسْتَطِبُّ الْقُرُوحُ وَيَبْرَأُ جُرُوحُ الْكَسِيرِ الْجَارِيحِ وَيَنْشَطُ ذَاكَ السَّقِيمُ الْعَلِيمُ وَقَدْ كَانَ بِالسُّقْمِ دَهْرًا طَرِيحًا.